Howdy, Cadre.
Mountain.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. Strap in. What? Okay. Probably in creative, eh? Yep. Oh. Hello there, friends. What? Yeah, like I said, I don't know what I'm doing. Oh boy, what am I getting myself into? Yeah, this was gonna be like a. Kind of creative mode. I don't know. I forget where I spawned. It's probably near that tree. Let's find out. Oop. Oh, humility in 3, 2, 1. It didn't work. Oh, here it comes. No? Nope. Okay. I was trying to figure out where spawn was here. Help me out, buddy. I think we're near spawn, eh? You two. Oh, you three. I must be too far away. Okay, there we go. Yeah, all right. It's like a fresh start. Don't even have a chest. Middle of the night. Get some action going. I hear ya. Oh, jeez. It's a great way to start a little survival endeavor. So I don't know if you're following along, you know I just had a rather frustrating experience in my infinite world. We'll go back and try and fix that later. But I just wanted a little bit of, I don't know, the start of a game is fun. I don't know why I'm here in Aether. Just a choice. Or I do know why. I do know why. I was thinking that this was the oldest. That's not what I want. It was what I wanted. I could have switched to stone and then gotten a stone, whatever. I'll use the axe. I looked at my playlist to figure out what the oldest Minecraft series was that I had abandoned. Oh, I did see something. I thought I saw some creeper skin. So anyway, I figured rather than abandoning this, and I was gonna rewatch the first episode, and I just not a big fan of watching my own videos. But, just from the title, I spotted that I had used it for, like, channel announcements and updates. Leave that big tree. And maybe that's what I'm about to do? Maybe this fits in that category that I'm updating you on the channel. I suppose I could have named it State of the Channel Address, as used to be my own particular idiom. But, there's an apple. I don't know. I don't know as there's much to update you on fully. My cat's health is slowly improving. Maybe some of you are wondering about that. I don't know. You know, I'm so out of touch with you guys. Did I say howdy cadre at the start? I don't even know. Why are you guys floating out here? Should have something to stand on to do this. Yeah, we're still in the middle of a contested election. Although it's just absolute bullshit that it's contested at all. That's not gonna work. Yeah, the more time passes, the more it's clear that it's just political strategies. And honestly, part of what frustrates me is the current president is taking advantage of his own core supporters at this point. He started a fundraising campaign. And for his less intelligent supporters, you know, the name of the fund is Election Defense Fund or something like that, but it's really a political action committee. Those are less regulated than they used to be. And it gives him a lot of flexibility in how he handles the funds. And for anybody willing to read the fine print, if you donate to him, 60% of the initial donations go to pay off his debts. I think that he's incurred during the campaign. So he ran his campaign, you know, this is, shouldn't be surprising to anybody that's paid attention to his businesses. But he's first using this new money to pay off his campaign debts, and then 40% goes to the Republican National Convention, which I'm sure was an agreement he made behind the scenes to get some of the mainstream, you know, Republican career politicians to support this effort. Because if 40% of the donations are going to the RNC, they can use that money however they want to promote their own interests. So I think because of that decision, there are more people willing to support this collection effort. Did I? Yeah, no, I did. Okay, good. So anyways, it's only after a certain threshold. I didn't, this is what I understand from the details from what I read. After they meet a certain threshold, the rest of the money will go to support these frivolous lawsuits and such. But yeah, the fact that the fine print makes this all clear is it's just mind-blowing that he would take advantage of his own supporters in this way. And he may, you know, there's rumors that he may continue it, that he may, as soon as he concedes, announce that he's running in 4 years. And what that will allow him to do is basically he's starting an ongoing campaign, so he can endlessly raise money from his His gullible supporters. Unprecedented. Unprecedented politics. How have I lost sight of that ship? There it is. It was silhouetted before, and then I got closer and it blended in with the ground. Do we have boats? Or boats? Do we have doors down here? No door. Okay. I know. I should make a door. I probably shouldn't make it underwater. Anyways, woo, politics. Pandemic. My governor just announced last night that we're we've got some new regulations coming in to try and fight the ooh. That is a lot of iron. Oh, what a great way to get started. Even a diamond. Don't care about that as much because, you know, what am I going to do? Make a jukebox? Make a shovel? Nope. I do not have lights. I just placed another. Didn't mean to do that. Haha! Found it in the dark. Carrots. Is that a door? Yes, there is a door here. Okay. Hey, buried treasure map. All right. Did I just go through night? No, it's setting. Okay. I am going through night now. So, and I even have people in my own family that seem to be anti-maskers. And, you know, it's understandable. We're all tired of staying at home. I mean, those of us that are, we're all tired of wearing masks. We all wish we were back. This isn't... Okay, no, there's the beehive. This is the way it came from. But I try to look at the facts and right now we are at the highest number of huh, you got a fishing pole. Not gonna drop it, huh?
Okay.
You know, we're at the highest number of new cases, and I think also the highest number of deaths since the pandemic started, and now it's spreading all through the state, not just in big cities. And this is driven by, you know, people kind of getting lax with following the rules, because again, we're all tired of it. And there's a psychological effect that, you know, you're told to do something to help improve the safety of your community, health of your community and everything. And you can't see the change. You can't see what effect you're having, because the effect you're having just is. It goes into the data. And obviously from the numbers, we're not doing enough to stop the spread of it. I mean, unless you deny that masks help, that social distancing help, or that even there's anything, you know, to be helped. Kind of reluctant to move right now. So anyways, it's interesting to see the difference between her announcement and the regulations. That her announcement, I think, is very focused on counteracting the dangerous anti-mask rhetoric, you know, that's come from our president as well as his supporters. And part of that group is anti-vaxxers that think the science is being used for political reasons. But that's a small subset of the Republican Party and its voters. How did you spot me? You coming this way? Hey there. I don't think you can jump in water. So anyways, her orders were focused on more social aspects. And maybe you guys might not be paying attention to Michigan, certainly. The governor had issued a mask mandate. And the political opposition, who thinks she's a Nazi trying to control our lives, started a legal battle to undermine that. And in response, our Department of Health and Human Services, I think that's the name, came out with their own mandate. So that even if her authority to do so was undermined or ruled against by a court, there was at least a official parallel from the department responsible for the health of our community. And, you know, it's not even a mandate that if you leave your household, you have to wear a mask. It's for public places where people gather, and that includes, you know, stores and private businesses. But the whole point is to make sure people are taking precautions that protect the public health and safety. Should I build out here? I don't really want to build out here, do I? That's right, I got iron. My third crafting table. I guess I'll build out here. Here. What do I want? Bucket. Shears would be good. And I guess it's time for a shovel. So anyways, it's real frustrating to me that, well, I just put that flower down. Sorry for the interjections. Get used to them. It's part of the cost of trying to talk about something unrelated while I Minecraft. It's frustrating to me that we're not only fighting this virus, but that we're also fighting people who deny that it exists or that it's not as serious. And you can look at the mortality rate and say, most of us will live through it. But to do that, you have to ignore the fact that it's, you know, the most marginalized among us, our grandparents, our cousins with immune system deficiencies or other conditions. Well, I guess I don't have to build right now that it's day. I've already made a portal to the Nether. Perhaps we should go there. It's not a smart decision, but it is an adventurous and curious one. I think there's a pre-made house down here. It's a wet house, but it is a house. Certainly enough room for a bed and a little bit of storage. The water could be dealt with. Alright, I had a... Yeah. Had a bench. Anyways, yeah, it's frustrating we have to fight each other. And it's easy enough to say, you know, if I'm concerned, I should wear a mask and then I'm fine. But it's certainly not as simple as that. And I don't... What am I doing? I don't just worry about myself. I worry about... Everybody who is not in control of their environment and situation as I am. I'm lucky enough to have been able to maybe I should plant these carrots. Oops. Yeah, I'll make it stone. How many do I have? 7. You should be able to plant apples. I mean, they do the same thing as saplings, but it should work. It doesn't work, does it? That's the sort of thing they could have updated at one point, and I'd not necessarily notice. Nope. I mean, admittedly, what would make more sense is... Yeah, that's just logistically a little bit confusing. Oh, sorry. I was going to stash... Just did that to myself. We'll need a hoe. Yeah. Let's go find some adventure. Establish ourselves in the Nether. I feel like I belong in the Nether regions anyway. Am I hearing fish? Maybe. Well, I sure didn't care about this coal when I was here last. In creative mode. Probably be a good thing to take with me. So anyways, yeah. That woman from Michigan, as the president dubbed her, her speech was focused on what people could do to protect their loved ones. And she called on people to not have large gatherings for Thanksgiving. And she tried to use next year kind of as a leverage point. This is going to overflow, ain't it? I got it. I got it. I know what I'm doing. I am a Minecraft hydro engineer. So yeah, her speech was focused on common sense things families can do, you know, protect you're elderly and more vulnerable. Yeah, this is gonna annoy me unless I just yeah. But the actual orders are focused on primarily businesses. And schools and such that represent the places where most of the spreading is believed to be occurring. So we're shutting down schools. We're stopping sports. Professional sports can continue if they take extreme measures to combat the virus, the spread of the virus. And no live audience allowed. So I think that's smart because people can watch sports on television and that keeps them safe from each other. And it's not just the attendees that matter. It's anybody in their family or that would, you know, shares a household with them. And right now, our hospitals are basically at capacity all across the state because of coronavirus. And that means it has effects on more than just people exposed to coronavirus, regardless of what your condition is. You know, if a third of the medical staff are sick. Well, even not that. If a third are at home under quarantine and a third are overworked and, you know, all quality of care goes down and all, you know, delays and, you know, they stop non-emergency medical procedures. So if you're trying to get something mildly corrective or preventative or cosmetic, you've got to just wait. All right, I don't have flint and steel. I guess I want to make my way up for a better view. So anyways, the order seems pretty sensical to me that it's, whoa, okay. It's focused on reducing large gatherings and, you know, shuts down less essential businesses, and the plan is a 3-week pause. I think they called it a pause. She's not calling it a shutdown. And indeed, you know, the designations of essential workers are still in place as exceptions, and I fit into that category for the one job I still have. And it still blows my mind that people think this is an encroachment on freedom. And the irony is not lost on me that this whole year has been dominated by the "I can't breathe" phrase, which has taken on extra meanings during the coronavirus. But you know, you can breathe through masks. It does not stop the oxygen. It is harder. That annoys me too. I have to take much, much deeper breaths. Early on, I was finding I was winding myself because I was breathing normally, you know, shallow breaths, and it would catch up with me. Even worse than that, I was avoiding exhaling. I hear ya. Oh, that's bad. That's bad. Yeah, I know how to deal with you guys. Oh, no, I don't. I do not. I didn't think he could hit me. Now I'm in a panic, and I'm running, and I don't want to stop to eat. Okay. Oh, yeah, no. I see ya. Perhaps my pillar was just not high enough. Okay. Crisis averted. I'm not wearing gold. I should be wearing gold. Let's rectify that as quickly as we can. Not what I meant to do. Okay. I have a pick. All right, let's go back where we came from. Do I have other food? I didn't bring enough stone to even make a furnace. Good. Whole reason I came out here was for a challenge. I converted all my wood. This is wood. That is a huge growth. I guess I hadn't seen a... What are these called? Hi-Fi? No, these are the Crimson... Yeah, Crimson Hi-Fi, right? Nether wart block. I don't know. Okay, where did I come from? That... Yeah, that was an indicator. Okay, so this is close to home. Oh, can I create a campfire? I'm short one stick.
Okay. Why did I want a campfire?
As a marker. I got a marker there, though. Yeah. Throw it down anyways. Oh, no, I wanted to cook my food. That's right. Oh, I don't want to lose my food, though. I think it just kind of pops off when it's done. Yep, lost one anyway. Maybe? Well, I did that. Oh, I made a home. Forgot. Made a double mushroom home. Well, let's go back and get whatever stuff survived. So yeah, we're shutting down schools, we're shutting down sports events, we're shutting down like theaters. Again, in restaurant dining, we're shutting down. All right. So I had gone up. It's up there, isn't it? And I did not bring tools. Which was a big mistake. I have nothing on me. So anyways, and yeah, the governor said, let's do this stuff so that we can gather with our loved ones normally next year. The experience burns up when it walks towards you. Oh, jeez. Well, some of my stuff survived. At least I have blocks. Some of my stuff did not survive. Oh, there's some more. Some more blocks I can save. I am coming, sprites. Sand. Oh, is that everything? Yep, everything else is gone. Including the armor I just made. Well, I am quite grateful my iron pickaxe survived. I don't even remember why I worked my way back down. I think I've been here before. Okay, I need to start over with wood. I have a little bit. Hey guys. So yeah, all right, Paul. It's oh, there's. I don't think I saw that before. Maybe I did. I probably did. It's been a while since I played episode one. Lost my pork chops. Well, I guess I should be careful because of that. My cat is recovering from her. Oh, I gotta call the vet. From her stroke. That's our best guess. Now I don't have stone. She's still moving carefully and gingerly, but she's not falling over as much now, and she's moving more and farther. She's been wandering out into the other room when I do, which, you know, after Halloween, she wasn't moving at all for a little while. I guess I'll take this with me instead of what I've been doing. Yeah, I have a dead YouTube channel. It's not a complaint. I don't blame anybody. I am sad of some of the changes that I think were contributing factors. You know, YouTube. And I'm also aware that, like, in a way, you know, when I joined, it was just a lot easier to get viewers because, the audience of viewers on YouTube was just hungry for stuff to watch, and early on there wasn't that much up. I remember when I first heard of YouTube, I thought it was for short clips of The Simpsons and stuff. And then I ran across, people doing skateboarding tricks and just posting it to share with friends or whatever. And I'm like, oh, you can just post whatever you want. And in a way, I was privileged to be able to join so early. Not just that I was there. But that I had access to a digital camera and a personal computer and I don't think I'm prepared for this. And even just the fact that I had enough free time to be able to record and post things. And, that's one of the things that's changed is now we all have smartphones in our pockets that can record us and connect with the internet. And so just with that one device, you can do what you need to. Okay. This is bad. I don't have food. I'm hurting myself. Maybe I can cheat the system. But the loss of response. Whoop, 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 whoop. Yep. Okay. The loss of response videos was a factor, a pretty big factor, because that was such a great way for anybody to try and reach out either to a creator or to a creator's audience. And when they removed that feature, I knew it was going to change YouTube quite a bit because it was a great equalizer. And it's partly what put the social in social media. And the loss of that has pushed the platform back to kind of the old model of media distribution, which is a few, mainstream personalities or whatever, the production companies, really. I mean, that's been another big shift, is that now to compete, you need like video editors, higher quality cameras. It's not true across the board. Some people are popular just live streaming without scripts and those other, production value aspects, but yeah, and the fights with the algorithms and is that a skeleton? No? Yes, no. It was smoke. Sorry. That snuck up on me. Oh boy, so yeah, I've just been here at home for the most part. I mean, I have been working less than normal. And I think as I may have referenced in my last video, I've been getting together with one friend about once a week to play cards. So that's been good. He and his wife are probably at higher risk of exposure than me, so that part's bad, but they're certainly in the camp of trying to be careful. I think what's going to be really hard to get is iron here. Think it's really only in chests. So mainly you got to look for fortresses. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't really know what my plan is, and I've probably already made a long enough episode that I should move on. And because I've fallen behind on recordings and lost control of any sort of upload schedule or routine. I love that purple. It's so nice that the nether's not just pure crimson anymore. Yeah, I've lost the flow of every series, so. And now that I'm jumping around between them, I'm just going to be constantly confused about the next best, or where I was at and what I was doing, and yeah, I probably should, maybe I should focus on one to get the flow back up. I was pretty annoyed at the explosion I caused in Infinite last episode. Just a dumb mistake with a new piece of equipment that I haven't used much, and yeah. Now I'm wasting all this time just trying to travel around a probably be making staircases and such. I should have brought my carrots with me. I think you can grow food in the Nether. You just got to bring dirt with you. They probably grow slower with the reduced light. But I'm not even confident how all that stuff works, so. Well, let's go grab some carrots, I guess. I was thinking I might just switch to nether living, but oh no. It's so much easier to deal with in water. You guys aren't good swimmers. And you guys don't like the water. Not that you mind it as much as Enderman, but anyway, so yeah, I'm kind of in a low energy state in general. And I apologize. You know, if anybody has any suggestions, I will certainly take them. I did myself the huge disservice of ignoring or deterring interaction when my channel was more popular. And now that I desire it more, of course it was the negative attention that led me to take that attitude, but you kind of got to realize that public works, there's going to be some good with the bad. And that's probably where my starter chest was. You know, you take the good, you take the bad, take them both, and there you have the facts of life. The facts of life. I started singing again. You know, last night I recorded myself singing and then I listened to it. Wasn't just that. There's a methodology problem. If you sing while listening to a song through headphones, you strip the recording of the music, which is nice for it's nice for the purposes of, I don't know what I'm doing, putting almost everything away. It's nice for the purposes of stripping the copyright problem. That you're basically recording an a cappella cover, which is obviously your own creation, other than the songwriting, I guess. But it creates other issues, like it's easy to shift pitch. And if your music's loud, it's hard to hear what pitch you're at or how. Yeah, anyways. So you end up with some note searching and such. Sounds pretty bad. So I probably won't upload that. Oh, unless somebody thinks it'd be funny or whatever. Are these done? Twas not. I think you gotta wait until their stems get quite a bit taller. I don't know. This was a useless episode. I'm sorry. I suppose it stands in contrast with my last episode, but yeah, if anybody has recommendations for what they'd like to see from me, feel free to leave a comment. I know with this Minecraft focus, my channel is much different than it used to be. And I certainly, whatever. Would like more interaction again. It's lonely out here in Whitmore Lake. I've even started writing a few of the channels I watch. Lesser known ones. Well, sometimes known ones. I send a message to Ethan and Mark. Actually, I did that back in May and they ignored me. And so I was trying, without spamming, I was trying to get through to them. And I sent messages through emails and different channels and different social media. And no response. I wasn't expecting a response. I was hoping for one. And certainly I wouldn't expect a response if I hadn't written. I even thought I might get attention of some of their viewers with the video I posted that was a response to them. And I posted it in a couple places. I was trying to avoid posting it publicly. Because I wanted to get their attention directly, not the attention of their fans necessarily. And I didn't want to look like I was trying to take advantage of their popularity to try and increase mine or something. And in fact, when I made that video, I put no keywords on it. So that I wouldn't even be scooping up people who were searching for hashtags or whatever. All right. There was something. A little bit of something. Insert catchphrase here.